Welcome to Sunny in Seattle with your host, Sunny Joy. And coming up on today's show, Sunny welcomes back one of her show's all-time favorite and most frequent guests, Sara Landon. And the two of them will be chatting about all the incredible wisdom she's been bringing through. So tune in for some serious energy and inspiration for your new year. And now I welcome your host for the day, Sunny Joy.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Sunny in Seattle. I'm your host, Sunny Joy McMillan, and we're here every Friday from 9 to 10 a.m. on Alternative Talk, 1150 a.m. KKNW in Seattle, as well as 103.3 KPCA in Petaluma, bringing you amazing guests and resources that will help you create a life filled with joy, peace, freedom, and purpose. It is radio that positively shines. And if you can't catch the show live, you can always access the show archives. Those are found at 1150kknw.com. You can also find the show on iTunes and Podcast One, and I think a couple of other podcasting platforms I found out in the last week. So, my website is goldenoversoul.com. And Benny, how are you doing today?
Doing very well. It sounds like your show is ever growing longer legs if you're extended further out in the outreach of the internets.
Yeah, I guess so.
It's good. It's a good thing, right?
I'm sure I get notifications about these things, and then like months later I see, oh my gosh, I totally missed that email that came through that this new and cool thing is happening at KKNW.
Well, it's that or just like you're now in Bali. Like, wow, we're in Bali. That's the best. By the way, yeah. I'd love to visit someday if anyone's welcoming to send me some airfare for that. I'd love to visit. Okay, just putting it out there. Okay.
You'd have to take off work for more than a day, Benny.
Oh, that's right, Sunny. You know I don't do that.
I know. Bali's kind of a hard one to hop off to for a 24-hour break.
Well, I might have to make an exception on that one.
Exactly. Well, so all is good up there?
Yep, peachy keen.
Okay. Well, good. Well, then I guess we'll dive in with our guest.
I think you should.
Well, we will. So I think many of our audience knows Sara Landon. I consider her not only a dear friend, but also one of my favorite spiritual teachers out there at this time. As many of you know, I keep a little, I call it my, you know, depending on the person I'm talking to, if they're kind of spiritual, I call it my vibrational speed dial list. If they're a little bit more of a muggle, I say emotional speed dial list. But Sara's work has been at the top three of that list for a long time. And those are just the resources and the teachings that I go to on a regular basis that I know dependably just can lift my spirits, you know, since we're just coming off of Dita Marie's show. Yeah, they really do lift my spirits. And so I'll just read Sara's bio and then we'll bring her on because, you know, these teachings that she has been bringing through for now many years, they really do build upon what's come before. And so, you know, we talk to her from time to time, although we realized it's been longer than I had hoped that it would be. I think April's last show we did together. But in any event, you know, these teachings have followed me on my path of growth. And I know they do for the people who really do enjoy them, do the same. And so really excited to hear kind of the wisdom that's been coming through as of late, as we enter this new year of 2021 and a lot of big changes. Passionate about living her highest potential, Sara Landon is a guide for leaders, wayshowers, and changemakers, contributing to raising the vibration of the planet. She shines a light on the path for others to expand beyond the perceived limitations of the human experience and live as the masters that they are while remaining grounded in the modern world. As the masterful channel of the Council, Sara focuses to be the ultimate student of the wisdom and teaching she receives and is committed to conscious, impeccable creation. Her intention is to be the purest channel of a grander perspective of what is possible and to help others discover that they have the same ability to connect to higher levels of consciousness and guidance. Her website is saralandon.com. That is saralandon.com. Sara, welcome back to Sunny in Seattle.
Thank you, Sunny. I am so happy to be here with you guys. This is one of my favorite things. I absolutely love this show, and I'm really glad to be here with you and Benny. And I have to say, in our little pregame warm-up, I'm like laughing now because I've known, you know, Benny for a few years now, but now that I know his secret, it's never going to be the same for me when I hear Benny talking because I know he's making love to the microphone, and it's just never going to be the same for me now that I know that. So I think we're going to have to do the show more often, just, you know, just because that makes me so happy.
Apparently that's broadcasting 101. Is that right, Benny? That's what they tell you?
I didn't know that.
Oh, no. Maybe Benny's in the aux studio helping Dina. Just to give everybody a little by way of background.
I've been doing it all wrong this whole time.
Apparently, Benny said that is what you are to do as you are talking into the microphone. So we'll have him elaborate on that when he comes back, I suppose.
Yes.
But anyway, Sara, it's so good to have you back. And as I said, you know, during our little pregame warm up, I mean, I would have you on here at least once a quarter. So hopefully we get back into a more regular schedule because I, you know, like I said, this is the things that I love. This is actually a new bio that I read, and I thought, you know, this is so, it is so perfect because it really is not only your life, and I'd love to share a little bit about your background, but, you know, your life, because of this wisdom that you've been bringing through from the council, it is an example of what is possible for us when we really are living our highest potential. And I think that's one of the reasons so many, including myself, are drawn to these teachings. They're just so uplifting. With that said, I know we've talked in varying degrees about your background and how you came to this work, and I'll just kind of give you the floor if you want to share as much or as little as feels good to you this morning about background, you know, who you are and the work you do.
Sure. Absolutely. Thank you for that. And I'll just do it briefly because I know many of the people listening have heard this before, but if you're new, just for those that are new, or you need a little refresher, I love that this is Sunny in Seattle show because so much of my life was in Seattle, and I have so many dear, amazing, wonderful friends there, although I know the show is much bigger than just the Seattle area, but I, for many years, was in the technology world in Seattle, and did all those things I thought I was supposed to do. You know, you go to school, you get the good job, you buy the house, you get married, you work hard, and by anybody's measure, for the most part, I was living this seemingly successful, wonderful life. And I really did feel blessed and fortunate. And I had followed this personal development path of set big goals, big audacious, hairy goals, and accomplish them, and all of that works. But I just didn't feel like I was living my purpose. I didn't feel like I was really living my life the way I intended to when I came into this human experience. I felt like I had a calling. I felt like I had a greater calling. I felt like I had some sort of mission. I had no idea what that was. I just knew whatever I was doing was not it, and I had no idea how I was going to go from the life I was living to figure out what I was supposed to do and get on that path and make that happen. I absolutely had no idea, and I can't even put into words how absolutely supported every single human being on this planet is if you will just open your heart and allow yourself to be guided, to follow the energy in things, to let the light guide the way for you. Your path will unfold no matter where you are or what situation you're in. If you will have the courage to just acknowledge your own inner truth, whatever that you deserve that you are worthy of that if you want more, if you want to make an impact, if you have a passion and yet feel responsible for all these things or feeling stuck or feeling like change is just so scary, I promise you, if you will have the courage to just follow your heart, to stand in your truth and set yourself free to really be who you are and remember why you're here and remember that your purpose is joy. It is to be all that you are. It is to live your life fully. It is to love fully. And I see this right now like I never have before. And the council, which we will talk about in a moment, mm-hmm. has said, you're going to see a mass conscious movement towards what we call revolution. Remember that your role in that revolution is to be love in action, consciousness in action. And while I'm seeing this in the collective, because so many people have felt isolated and repressed for so long now, or almost a year into this experience of COVID, mm-hmm. while I'm seeing it in the collective, I am seeing it on a personal level in people's lives in a way I never have before, that people are feeling this absolutely undeniable desire, need to live their truth, to cultivate the freedom in their life, to do what they want to do, to be who they want to be, to live the life they want to live. And behind every single thing that we think we want is freedom.
Yeah.
We want freedom and we want love. We want freedom and we want love. And you can have them both. You really can. You know your truth. Most all of us do, even if it's just general. Even if it's when I ask you, what is it that you want to experience? What do you want more of in your life? More peace, more joy, more abundance, more beauty, more fun, more time to create the things you want to create and to play and do the things that are fun for you. You can have all of that, even if you don't know what that looks like specifically. And so I never, ever, ever could have imagined that after many years in the corporate world, climbing that ladder, achieving all these goals, I was telling, I'm doing a business strategy series with a group of people within our master's class. And I said yesterday, one of my biggest goals in my whole life was to be in a large global, you know, company and be part of the management and leadership and executive team doing super cool things all over the world. And I got there and I was like, okay, this is great, but why don't I feel as happy and fulfilled and successful as I thought I would feel? And if anyone would have told me at all, you're going to leave the corporate world and you're going to go down a spiritual path of living your highest potential and discovering what that is. And part of that highest potential is going to be doing this thing called channeling. And you're going to channel this higher level consciousness and speak to people about consciousness and awareness and expanding their vibration into higher states of consciousness and channel this thing called the council. I would have been like, no freaking way am I doing that at all. Like, no, thank you. You've got the wrong person. There must have been a mix up. But I can say now on the other side of that, I truly live a life beyond my wildest dreams. I could not be happier. I feel such a deep sense of purpose every single day. And I get to collaborate and create and live this wisdom with amazing people like you and all of those that are part of the council's teachings and wisdom. So let's just quickly demystify the council and channeling and all that stuff really quickly. If you're new to channeling, if you're new to all of that, channeling is a very natural thing. We all do it, whether you're aware of it or not. Athletes or musicians that are what you call just in the zone, right? When they are just so in the flow and so connected to source energy and they do amazing and extraordinary things. You do the impossible. You play this perfect ballad or perfect song or melody or music and you're just in the flow and it's flowing through you, or you're skiing down the slopes and you're just so, you're channeling source energy in that moment. You're open, you're allowing, you're connecting to the source, you're letting all of the energy that is you flow through you. That's why that feels so amazing. That's why it is an experience beyond time and space, where you lose track of time or you're not thinking about anything else because you're so in the moment. Many people, when you're having a conversation with someone and you're just so focused in the moment, you're opening and allowing that source energy, and people say, Oh, the words just came through me. I don't even know what I just said. Where did that come from, right? That is a form of channeling. You are open to source energy and it's just flowing through you. That's a very natural thing. Channeling is to completely open up to the source energy that is always available to you. And in that is a higher level of consciousness and awareness, a grander perspective of who you are and why you're here and what's possible for your life, a grander perspective of the human experience and what it's really about. And so some people experience that like automatic writing, when moving their body or dancing or singing or doing athletics. I happen to experience it verbally. So I close my eyes and I take a few deep breaths and I raise my vibration, which is a natural experience now after many years of doing it, to a place where I come into connection with this higher level of consciousness. And then the words, the higher level of consciousness is translated into words that flow through me that, in my opinion, is the greatest wisdom I've ever come across on this planet that has just answered every question I had. I just never expected it to come through me. So as the council has said, they don't need a name. They don't care what they're called. They are not attached to any of that stuff, you know, but they understand that we are in the human experience. And they've said the greatest thing closest to explaining what we are would be the council, a collective of this higher level intelligence that's coming together and streaming through. And on many occasions, they've explained it's my higher self, your higher self, Sunny, the higher self, the awareness of everyone that's here, that's listening to it now or ever will, is part of that collective of the council. So hopefully that demystifies a little bit, makes it consumable for everyone. I know many people have never been exposed to channeling, and some people have followed Abraham Hicks or read the Seth Speech books or read A Course in Miracles, you know, all of which are channeled experiences or channeled texts or teachings. And so sometimes you've been exposed to it, maybe don't even realize it.
Exactly. Yes. And I can't remember if I have shared, it's been a long time since I shared this, but I just, the way that you and I, where I found, or I guess your work more found me, we had a mutual friend in Seattle. And I think this is just, I want to share this just because I think it is an example of following the energy, letting the light guide the way. I'd really like to have you speak more to that also sometime on the show today, what that actually looks like. But on that note, we had a mutual friend in Seattle, and she knew that I had the Sunny in Seattle show at the time, and it was, I think, I'm in its second year or something like that. And she also knew that I was interested in science and spirituality and all that kind of good stuff. And she said, "You've got to listen to this channel teaching." It's from a friend that I know. Her name is Sara Landon, and so I listened to it, and I immediately just went, "Oh, wow." It reminded me, I guess Abraham Hicks was my gateway drug to channeling. So there were some things about it. And I was like, oh, wow, this reminds me a little bit of that. And so I reached out to you and you came on the show, and it just has been a snowball from there. And I just still to this day am so grateful to our mutual friend for having introduced me to your work, because it was a collaboration, not only on a friend level, but also just how much it has enriched my life. And I'm so glad that, as I've said on the show before, I feel very blessed. There's so many people who have such wonderful work out in the world. And I get so many emails, you know, listen to this person, try this, read that. And I can only do so much with the time that I have. And yours was one of the ones that just kind of lit up, and I knew I had to listen to it. And so here we are. So thank you for following the light and the energy in your life to bring this to fruition and make it available to so many people.
Yeah. Yeah. It's truly my joy, Sunny Joy McMillan.
Pun intended, I'm sure. Yeah. So do you mind speaking a little bit? Because when we talk about following the energy and letting the light guide the way, I think I know what that is. I feel like if I was to use an example from my life, our move to specifically Petaluma, California from Seattle felt like that to me. I am curious what that has either looked like in your life or any examples you want to share, because if someone hears that, they may go, well, God, that sounds well and good, but what does that actually mean? And when you're in a human experience, in a culture, that's not really what we're brought up to believe what we should be doing, you know?
Yeah, it's a really good question. And it seems ambiguous or esoteric until you start living it, and then you go, oh, wow, this is so much easier, and I should have been doing it this way all along. And you realize right. how many times you actually have. So like your move, like anybody's move, all of a sudden one day you wake up and you're like, this isn't where I belong anymore. This house doesn't feel the way it used to feel. This place doesn't feel. You have expanded. You are always changing, elevating, creating. And in that, oftentimes you're raising your vibration, you're elevating your consciousness. And the more you do that, you begin to be aware of the energy that is in things, in a relationship, whether it's a romantic relationship or a friendship, in a living situation, in a job, in a place. We can go to a place and feel, oh my gosh, I belong here, or ooh, this is not my place, right? Mm-hmm. So energy is always guiding you. We are energy. That is what we are. Energy can never be created nor destroyed. It just changes form. That's what we are. We are energy and consciousness focused in physical form to have this magnificent human experience. But you are energy. You are light. That is what you are. And so it only makes sense that that energy and light that you are, that is part of all that is always guiding you. And if you will get in alignment to that and stay in the flow of that and not let your fear and self-doubt and lack and limitation hold you in a place that you've expanded beyond, it becomes really easy to follow the energy and let the light guide the way. Now, a big part of that is being able to stay conscious, being able to communicate consciously, and being able to stay loving, being that consciousness and love in action in your life as you're navigating through creation. We use the word change, and I would invite you to replace the word change in your life with the word creation. There are not big changes happening. There is big creation happening in your life. You're not dealing with a lot of change. You are dealing with a lot of creation. That's an empowering, uplifting vantage point of what's going on in your life. Ooh, change is happening to me. Ugh. But change is always happening. It's going to always happen. And the more you can embrace it as creation and expansion and ways to greater express yourself and experiences that are being orchestrated for you, experiences that you're choosing because you want to live fully in your life, then you can navigate through change or creation in a whole different way. And then you can get in a place when you're open, when you're allowing, where energy and light will always guide the way for you. So a relationship, whether it's a friendship or a romantic relationship, sometimes the energy just isn't there. We all know what that feels like. It might just be a day-to-day thing. In that moment, on that day, you are just in two, there's the law of resonance, which is that your vibrations are always seeking to resonate. And if someone's in a really high vibration and someone's in a really low vibration, if you walk into that room and you're in a high vibration, you will be like, there is no energy and no light in this. And if you would have checked in before you walked in the room from a conscious perspective, you might have not walked in that room because the energy and the light was not guiding you there.
Yeah.
But this, again, is the importance of consciousness, communication in your life, is that we do things we think we have to do. We create these stories, oh, I have to do it. They're my friend, or I have to do it. They're my partner. I have to do it. And that's very disempowering. That is how we hold ourselves apart from the freedom that we really do have to live our truth in a way that is conscious and loving and even kind. So a job, oftentimes people will be like, I hate this job. I don't want to be here anymore. I don't belong here anymore. Well, at some point in time, that job you really wanted And you were excited when you got it, and it lit up for you, and all the energy was in it. But especially people that are on the spiritual conscious path of personal development and human potential and all the things that you teach and share with the world, Sunny, you are probably expanding pretty quickly if you're on that path. And so you follow the light to a certain opportunity or relationship or a place, and you gathered the data and the information, you expanded, you found ways to express yourself, you had a new experience, and now the light and the energy is guiding you to the next level of potential and possibility based on the vibration and the consciousness you're in. And yet most of the time we create a story why we can't follow the energy and the light that is always there to guide you if you will allow it. However, here's the thing about the energy and the light, that most of us want to know, where am I going to be a year from now? What's my 3-year plan, right? You don't know where the energy and the light is going to be anywhere other than this moment. So to follow the energy and the light, you have to be in the moment. To be in the moment, you can't be in resistance in the moment. You can't be reacting to the moment. So if you don't have the money you think you should have, and you're in resistance or reaction, or you're feeling lack or limitation, you're not really fully in the moment. So it might feel like there's no energy guiding you. It might feel like there's no light here for you. And because of that, you go to your limited human senses, you try to figure it out, and you try to push and force energy where you think it should go. And then everything's a struggle. Everything's frustrating. It doesn't work. And even if you do make something happen with your limited viewpoint of taking action to what you think is the only way to fix this problem, the manifestation will still be based in lack and limitation, because that was the energy that went into it when you created whatever that solution was.
Yeah.
Years ago, I read Eckhart Tolle's The Power of Now, and I'm like, this is like, I don't know how this is going to help me be more successful. I don't know how this is going to make me more money. I don't know how this is going to make my relationships better. Fast forward, we'll just call it 10 or 15 years. Oh my goodness. The power of the moment is everything. And yet most of us want to just skip right over the moment and go to, I need this, I need that, I want this, where am I going? What am I going to do a month from now? What am I going to do a year from now? Is this person my soulmate? How do I lose 10 pounds? I want to make more money. We don't want to, like, we're in resistance to what is. And yet, all of your power is in the now moment.
Yeah.
The energy and the light that is always guiding you is in the now moment. The council says the formula for creation. If you want more money, if you want a better body, if you want to create a relationship, if you want to improve your relationship, if you want to move to a new place, whatever it is, the energy for creation is consciousness moves energy into form. You have to elevate your consciousness to a level where you are truly in the experience, feeling it in the moment, that every cell of your body is aligned with the abundance that you want to create more of. And so as you elevate your consciousness, you open and allow energy, all the energy that's here to serve you. Everything is energy. Source, God, all of it is energy. Magic, miracles, all those things that you want are energy. So when you expand your consciousness, when you elevate your perspective, your awareness, you allow more energy, more light, and that's what moves creation into form. But it's all done through the moment. And so in every moment, there are multiple different dimensions of consciousness that are available to you. I won't go too much into it. We talk a lot about it in our master's class program and our different courses, but most people don't realize that there's something available in the moment beyond the third dimension. The third dimension is just simply a state of consciousness, but the basis of it is separation, which creates lack, limitation, struggle, suffering. It's this fighting against what's right, what's wrong. It's this experience of time and space and death and lack that that creates the struggle within the human experience, creates the suffering within the human experience. And yet all of us know somewhere within us there is this thing called heaven on earth. And if you are an Eckhart Tolle fan, you've probably even heard the term a new earth, or if you're on a spiritual path or in this personal development space, you've probably heard a lot about a new earth. A new earth, a heaven on earth, a higher potential, possibility, a miraculous life. You know, we all within us somewhere go, oh yeah, like I want that. And somewhere within you, you know it's possible for you because it's already here in this moment, available to you. It's just in a different state of consciousness beyond lack and limitation. But you are, and here's a really important thing, you are never going to rid this world of the lack and the limitation and the fear and the struggle and the separation that exists within the third dimension of consciousness. When you are in a lower state of vibration, when you're in a lower frequency, you're in a lower state of consciousness. We are never going to rid this world of what is in the third dimension of consciousness. But you can elevate yourself and your entire human experience, your life and your experience, out of that lower dimension of consciousness or that lower vibration. And so as you do that, as you elevate, and just briefly, the fourth dimension of consciousness, a little higher vibration, where you start asking, who am I? Why am I here? You start going into transformation. The fourth dimension is a dimension of transformation. I'm not my circumstances. I'm not my conditions. I can change them. I can heal. I can fix myself. We often go through that for many, many years. And then we come to a place of going beyond judgment of yourself and others and circumstances and conditions, and you begin to elevate yourself into the fifth dimension of consciousness, which is pure love, realizing that God, Source, the Divine is in you, it's in everyone, it's in everything. You come into a much higher viewpoint of this human experience. Everything's happening for you. Everything truly is serving you. You know that there's only love from the highest level. You can elevate your perspective into this fifth dimension of consciousness. From that state of pure love, your well-being and your abundance is assured. Things come to you even before you know you need them because you have elevated yourself and your consciousness and your experience out of that lack and limitation. So you don't have to experience the lack of something to create more and to expand into more. And so you're never going to rid this world of fear in the third dimension, but you can elevate your experience beyond it. And as you do, you create a path. You make it easier for others to do the same. And the way I see it is, you know, this vision in my mind where we're all stepping out of the third dimension, or what might be called the old earth, into this higher vibration and consciousness that is becoming more and more and more available to us the more that wake up and start living in these higher dimensions of consciousness. But how else will you seed humanity with a greater potential and possibility for their own lives if it's not your reality? You can't wish abundance for someone from a place of lack. You can't get sick enough to make a sick person well. You have to elevate yourself out of this, which creates a pathway for everyone who's ready and willing and wants it and is able. And then we walk into a higher dimension of consciousness, into a grander experience of this human life that's available to everyone. But as you get into these higher vibrations, you allow just the most miraculous things to come to you. You follow the energy, you let the light guide the way, you really trust yourself. You really trust yourself to stay conscious in every moment. That's the ultimate secret to life right there. You would never fear anything. You would never worry. You would never try to, you wouldn't just rehearse the story over and over and over again in your head of what could happen or what might happen or what if they say this or what if, you wouldn't fear anything. You wouldn't worry if you knew that you could stay conscious in the moment no matter what. Which means that if someone starts yelling at you or getting upset, that you don't get triggered and into a state of reaction where you start fighting and arguing, that you know that you can, no matter what, be aware of your vibration and your consciousness in the moment and stay in your power and embody your truth. And this is where we are right now. And this is going to be more important than ever before. I absolutely know this. We are creating our own revolutions in our own lives, but you're going to see it in the collective. You're literally going to see your life go to the next level, but you've got to stand in your truth and you've got to be love and consciousness and action no matter what. And yeah, I'll take a pause there because you always have the best questions.
No. I don't want to interrupt you, but I do. I did want to ask because we're kind of transitioning into, I mean, the topic of the show today is, you know, your revolution of love and consciousness. And I know you've got the upcoming course, Revolution 2021, that's starting here in just a day or so. The information on that is at saralandon.com. And we'll talk a little bit more about that at the end of the show as well. But, you know, the word revolution, particularly right now, coming off of the events that we witnessed earlier this month at the Capitol, the word revolution can be a scary word, Sara, I think, for a lot of people, or it carries a connotation that can engender some fear. And I would love to hear you speak to what revolution means, say a little bit more about what that means in our individual lives and collective from that place of love and consciousness versus maybe how we see it sometimes playing out in a very third dimensional way in other places.
Yeah, I anything can be positive or negative, and that's kind of based on the level of consciousness you're in, right? Some of those definitions is, you know, this forceful energy, but a revolution is a rising up. It's a rising up. It's an opportunity to revolve, evolve, rise up in your life and in the world. And so many people have felt really repressed, really isolated over the last year. Mm-hmm. And the council's perspective is this is the greatest transformation of human consciousness that has ever occurred in human history. What is going on right now? The greatest innovation, the greatest technological advancements, the greatest medical advancements, the greatest personal advancements in your own freedom, in your own creativity, in your own clarity that has ever happened before. This is, in my opinion, the greatest opportunity that we will probably see ever in our lifetimes to really step into being all that we are. We've had the space, we've had the time, we've had all the wisdom is here, all the opportunity. I mean, it's here. People want to go back to the way it was. We're rising up into some other way of being. That's what's possible for us if we'll embrace it. And the council says, elevate yourself into this new earth experience that is here for you, right? That is really this revolutionary shift into living a life that, I explain it this way. People say, well, you can't just be joyful and happy all the time and everything's perfect. Why not? If you can really stay conscious, if you can really stay conscious, and that when you have a moment, and this is how I experience it, when I have a moment that something's not okay, I know I'm in resistance and reaction in the moment. And it's kind of that little girl part of me that doesn't know what I know, doesn't have the grander perspective that you've acquired throughout your life experience. And in that moment, it's having compassion for yourself, being gentle on yourself, kind, slow down, make some space for yourself, make yourself important in that moment, know that you being gentle and loving and kind to yourself in the moment is the most important thing. Then you get that little girl or little boy on board and in a better feeling place. And then the spectrum of your life is peaceful, satiated, content, present in the moment, aware, conscious. And the other end of the spectrum is bliss, inspiration, energy, vitality, miracles, just this incredibly magical place that happens from time to time when energy is really high and things are really aligned and you're really in the flow. And then the other end of the spectrum is not fear and helplessness and lack and limitation. The other end of the spectrum is total contentment, acceptance of the moment. When we accept what is, when we're in the moment and we accept what is without resistance and reaction, the instant manifestation is peace. And so this can be a very peaceful revolution in your own life. This can be a very peaceful revolution in the world around you. But if you are focused on the chaos, if you are focused on the suffering, if you are focused on what's wrong, if you are focused on the fight or you're fighting against, that energy has to go through you first. If you want to go fight against a cause, just know that you are moving that fighting energy through your body first before you're focusing out in the world. And is that really what you want to project through your body? Because I believe this is the number one reason we have such a issue with cancer on our planet. What is cancer? It's that the cells begin to fight you, right? Cells in your body turn inward and start to fight against you. Well, if we've been projecting this fighting against energy externally all the time, fighting against your competitors, fighting against your spouse or your partner, fighting against the Republican or Democrat or your political party, fighting against, warring against, all, you think it's going out there. It's not. It's all internalized. You are a universe within you. And I can say that as someone who myself has had cancer. I look at that point in time in my life, I was in a super competitive, fighting against all sorts of things world. I was in a super stressful relationship that had a lot of that energy and a spouse that lived in that energy. And that was my environment. So how is that surprising then when the cells in your body respond absolutely perfectly to the energy that you're projecting in them, which is that fighting against? Now, that being said, and I say this with all of my love and all of my heart and absolutely no judgment, nobody would ever consciously, intentionally create a disease or drama or death or, you know, these things that we go are so unwanted, truly. We don't realize that another potential is available to us. And one of the things that keeps us really stuck in the fourth dimension, which is at least a better place than the third dimension, you know, you're not your circumstances and conditions. You know that you have the ability to transform things, but what keeps people stuck there and not in that heaven on earth, pure love state is judgment. So what I see a lot of times of that, how do you really elevate yourself into a higher level of consciousness is you've got to let go of the judgment of yourself. And sometimes, especially the most wise spiritual people get caught in this place of constantly trying to heal themselves and fix themselves. And then they get into shaming themselves for what they have created. And that just keeps them stuck. And so notice when you're shaming yourself, there is a different energy in knowing that your perspective, your perception is creating your reality. And that as you become aware of how a belief or a story that you had created your reality, instead of judging it, you can go, wow, that worked perfectly. Now, it's not what I wanted, but it worked actually perfectly. So if I get in alignment to a higher perspective of what's really possible here, I could create a different reality that is wanted, that is what I want to experience from a conscious place, but without the shame. Of course, when we know better, we do better, and no one would intentionally create disease or decay or destruction within the body. We just don't realize how powerful we are sometimes.
Yeah. And another thing, you know, that I think as you're talking, when we do have those kind of experiences that are deemed in from the human perspective negative or bad, I, from having followed you in the council for some time now, anytime something happens that I would normally deem as bad, I ask myself, okay, if it is true, and I do believe this, but if it's true that everything is happening for me, everything is happening through me, why might that be? And that reframe really helps me get out of the self-judgment or the fear or the doubt and look at it as kind of getting back on the track of following that light and the energy. This is happening for me. Even if I'll just use, for example, you know, like our living situation. I think our timeline has sped up for when we maybe leaving this particular property where we've been for the last couple of years since landing in Petaluma. And initial reaction is, ah, no way. Ugh. And then I think, no, wait, if this is happening for me, if this is happening through me, why might this be the most perfect thing that could happen? And then boom, you're off and running with all potentials you can't even begin to imagine about what is possible if we lean into this instead of resisting and dig our heels in and try to stay, you know?
Exactly, exactly. You're so right. And I know that feeling of like, this is terrible. Why is this happening? And then you go, wait, what if this is happening for me? And then all of a sudden your whole like outlook just changes. You're like, oh, yeah, what if it's that? What if it's this? Oh, what about this? Well, that, whoa, like it just changes everything. And it's such a simple, simple, simple concept that you can do no matter what.
Yeah, that is revolutionary to me.
That is revolutionary to me too. I'm with you on that. It's just this, no matter, and think about it in your life. The things that at the time you thought might have been the worst things that ever happened to you, or could possibly ever happen to you. And a year later, or 3 years later, or 5 years later, you're like, whoa, that was one of the best things that ever happened to me. I just couldn't see it at the time, right? Countless times, especially now, people will say, oh, I lost my job, or I got laid off. And at the time, it's scary, and there's so much fear, and yet they never would have started their business, or they never would have then moved to this place, or they never would have then found this job or even been looking for this other job that ended up being so much better. Same with a relationship. You know, one person in the relationship recognizes that, whether they're consciously able to communicate it or not, that the energy is no longer in this, and they make the really hard decision to end it. And if you're on the side of that where they're, you know, you think this is happening to you, they're breaking my heart, they're ruining my life, right? And then a year or two later, you meet someone, or a month later, or 6 years later, you meet someone, and you go, oh, wow, I see why that other relationship didn't work.
Yeah.
I have to share this because one of our master's class members, who is going through this series that I teach about learning how to channel yourself, which is one of my passions of supporting people and how they open up their own channel to receive all this information in whatever way is exciting or interesting for them. But she said, you can never have a broke, your heart can never be broken when you are love. If you truly are love, your heart can never be broken. And I thought, oh, you know, when we're in that belief that something's happening to you, and yet in that moment, you're not aligned with the love that is here for you and that is you, and you feel broken. It goes back to this. So many times people say, I just want to be inspired. I just want inspiration. I'm waiting for inspiration. There's no, I don't feel inspired. The most important thing you can do in that moment, just take a deep breath, you know, take three deep breaths, close your eyes for a moment, and then shift your awareness to, how can I be inspiring to someone? Maybe just going to the grocery store or out for a walk and, you know, just looking up at the trees and putting a smile on your face and getting some light in your eyes. You go for a walk and you say hi to everyone you meet and you smile and you wave to them and you say hello. Isn't it a great day? Have a great day. And you get back home and you are going to feel so inspired, so inspired. And that's how you align with inspiration. And that's when the inspiration comes. One of the other things I've been practicing a lot is, you know, in those moments when you sort of feel lonely or kind of alone or a little bit isolated, it's like, who in this moment might be feeling even more alone than me? And my grandmother is in a nursing home in the Midwest, hasn't seen our family, hasn't been able to go see her. My grandfather died a few years ago. My grandmother is always the person that I can call and go, talking to her, being love in that moment so that she feels a little less alone. There's no way you're going to get off that phone call and feel alone. You're going to feel connected. You're going to feel love. And not only did you create it for yourself and within your own experience, you expanded that into inspiring, loving, caring energy in someone else's life as well. There's no lack of ways to live your purpose in every moment and every day as often as possible. Those are examples of really living and embodying your purpose. So when someone, and I was this person, so I have a lot of compassion for it. This, I don't know what my purpose is. Like, what am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to be doing? What's my purpose? Somebody please tell me. Angels, guides, Jesus, please. Someone tell me. You know, I'll do it, whatever it is. Just tell me. And then they told me, and I was like, oh, well, not that. That's a no, 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 no. Something else. Wrong person. Next. No, that wasn't me. No, I'm just kidding. But every day, every moment is an opportunity for you to really live your purpose.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. And I know we are at the tail end of our hour, and I'm just going to say, you know, for our wonderful KPCA folks here in Petaluma, we're going to let you go now because we're going to do a little promotion, not allowed on non-commercial radio, as we can wrap up our final few minutes here in our Seattle broadcast. So, Sara, I know that you have got, and I know we've got like just a minute left or so, but Revolution 2021 starts, I think, tomorrow, and it's going to be going days, January 23rd through February 20th. Anything, I mean, like the 32nd, like, and go to saralandon.com for more information on that. But Sara, what do you want to say in our final minute about that?
Oh, I just hope if this resonates with you, if you feel called, if it's choiceless, I hope you will join us for this new, it's a 5-part, all new channeled course video experience. It's live, but many people take the courses at future dates or later on, and it's exactly perfect whenever you hear it. But we're going to be talking about creating a clear vision, how you realize heaven and earth or the new earth in your life, elevating your experiences and living beyond lack and limitation, separation. We'll go more into that. How to create peaceful transformation in your life, choosing the path of love and consciousness, heart-centered expression, how to speak your truth to inspire and uplift and create the change you want in your life, or to create the what it is you want in your life. And then we're going to be talking about global convergence. How do we really embodying mastery and oneness in our experience and in a new earth? So Revolution 2021. It starts January 23rd. It's a 5-week channeled course video experience. So I hope I'll see you all there. I said this the other day in our master's class. It makes me almost emotional. I have never been more moved and more touched and more inspired for any course we have ever created. I am so excited for this. So I'll see you there. You can go to saralandon.com. We also did something really cool for this course, which is a choose your price. So you get to choose between the different price points of whatever feels right and aligned with you, just in the spirit of exchange and really coming into this new potential for what's possible for us on a lot of different levels. So we're excited about that. I'll
awesome.
See you guys
we're
there.
Like- Like Go 5 seconds, Sarah.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. I love you guys. Thank you.
Thank you, Sara Landon, for visiting and for everyone out there in the sunny in Seattle audience. Thanks so much, and I'll see you next week.